Warning. Elements of real-world religion are used in this podcast to serve the purposes of a work of fiction. They are to drive the drama forward and are not intended to be taken as a statement of opinion by the players. Thank you for listening.
I just want to let you know that almost immediately after I left the tent, I'm going to plop down and start doing an augury as a ritual.
Okay.
So it's 10 minutes, whether anything happens in 10 minutes.
This takes 10 minutes, so okay. Augury resolves. What happens?
So, blah, 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 blah. DM chooses from the... Okay, so, I receive an omen from an otherworldly entity about the results of a specific course of action that I plan to take within the next 30 minutes, and that course of action is allowing this to continue. That's the course of action I'm asking what will happen. The DM chooses from the following possible omens. It'll be wheel for good results, woe for bad results, wheel and woe for both good and bad results, or nothing for the results that aren't especially good or bad.
It sounds like it's
left first. It's a second level spell, or it's a second level spell, so it's, you know, it's not like solving the universe. But
it sounds like it's left pretty intentionally vague. But does it give you any idea who the otherworldly presence is giving you the information?
No. It's receive an omen from an otherworldly entity.
You receive wheel and woe, and you get a very malicious response.
Okay. Spell doesn't take into account any other possible circumstances, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Yeah.
I was bargaining specifically for, and I'll give you some insight into Jed on this, a plus one revolver.
Yeah.
We can do better than plus one. It's going to be something.
Okay. I'll let you figure that out. The insight I was going to give you on Jed on this, and this is something that's not privy to the rest of the party, but it's probably something that Christine would have been able to glean. The reason Jed shoots first so often is because he's always carried with him this self-doubt that in a fair fight, he's not going to cut the mustard. Mm. So he takes all these sort of half-cheating advantages in order to make sure he wins fights.
That's good.
Sweet. Yeah.
But he doesn't reveal that, and he doesn't even necessarily have considered his own self enough to be able to articulate that, but that's the case. He's concerned that in a toe-to-toe fight, when it comes down to the gunfight at high noon in the town square with Guthrie, he'll lose that fight.
What you receive as your blessing, for the time being, the piercing damage type becomes necrotic damage.
Okay.
Ooh.
When targeting your preferred opponent, it is a plus one weapon that deals plus 1d6 additional necrotic.
Okay.
When you fulfill your end of the bargain,
mm-hmm.
it becomes a plus one weapon in general,
mm-hmm.
plus two against Celestials.
Ooh, okay. All right.
Tits.
Plus two tits?
Yes. On the way out, as I'm being, like, ousted, like, get out! Levi will, get out the door and blow a kiss. Well, Christine, you... And Molly, Christine, you wore me out. My goodness. My loins are sore, and I drop the anchor head by the steps.
Let's get out. You realize you drop it right beside a tattered, moth-eaten nun's habit.
Huh? Ooh. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Is this Sister Agatha?
I will grab it. I'll grab it, the habit. And
do you shake the habit?
A little bit, yeah.
Do you kick the habit?
I won't yet drop it like a bad habit.
It is a bad habit. It's got holes in it.
I wonder why nobody called her out for that.
Because we're all too drunk to realize
that's
my fault.
Levi was all about it. He was in the moment. He's trying to get us through this.
I was all about fat Lou.
So his after making those jokes and doing those actions, he will his smile will remain as he faces you guys, and then immediately fade to a neutral expression. Let's go.
So, Jed's revolver, now that it's magic, if you'll allow me to elaborate a little bit on this, you now notice that along the barrel, winding around the barrel, in sunlight, it looks kind of like maybe ivory has been engraved around the barrel. At night, it's very clearly a vein, and in the quietest times, you can hear the gun has a subtle heartbeat.
Whew.
Wow.
Grim and dark.
Thank you. And vaguely phallic.
So I thought you were going with that.
Maybe not so vaguely.
Now let's get going back to the town before dirt is put on the boy. Gideon, Levi seems much more curt than usual.
I want to do one more one round skill challenge as you depart the spirit lands.
Okay. Do we have time for a quick little conversation on the way out of the hag's place?
Absolutely. You don't have time for a rest. You have plenty of time for RP.
I don't need time for RP. I don't need your rest. As he's leading them, as he's going out, Levi says, "Why did you allow yourselves to take the deal when I could have taken it all for you?" You couldn't let me do the right thing. Now you're both cursed.
Mr. Williams, you travel with other people. Other people take part of the deal, so you don't have to take all of it.
He doesn't look in your direction.
Well, shit, I'll just say it. I wanted what she was offering.
So did I, Jed. But thankfully, you did not hear that. And I did not accept. And, Elk, I apologize. I believe the mood got the better of me. Not a common occurrence, I assure you. I'm back to normal now.
Wow, I had something in my head and then I lost it.
Believe we found the remains of the sister. At least we can return to the remaining Aaronite and tell him that there's no hope and that he should move on.
You have made the choices you have made. There's no turning back now. And then I turn and I head back in the same direction we came, but I'm doing that same chanty thing I did that tried to orient you into the reality the first time, and I'm doing that off of
shaking maracas.
But I walk slow, so
of course, lead the way.
Jed sort of wheels his horse around, like, well, goddamn it, Elf, we're all just men, aren't we?
Shit.
Well,
that's the thing.
Three of you are.
One round skill challenge, who wants to go first?
Is this to get out of the spirit lands?
Yep, get back to town.
I'll do the whole nature thing again with the grounding and all that bullshit.
Okay, grounding and all that bullshit.
And all that bullshit.
There's a song and dance number with the spooky music.
I got something, and you might like it. You might like it enough for it to actually work.
Ooh, that's going
to
be a 21.
21 is humongous, so... Alright, who's next?
I'll go. Josh is still figuring out.
No, I got it. I was just checking something.
Right on. Who wants to take the reins? Is it the two of you? What's happening?
So, kind of, Levi will... This is a deception check against myself. To make sure that I don't get lost or separated and cause some delay. He will be seeing a vision... a rather type 3 vision of himself. That should mean only something to Ben.
Yep.
And...
I'm picking up what you're putting down.
He'll simply be feeling that itch, and he will mutter to himself, "No. It need not be achieved that way. There's other ways." I deceive myself at 17.
It's huge, yeah. You're able to push the images out of your head.
Things are different now. He will be saying these things out loud.
You definitely detect the conflicting nature of what it is you're referring to and your alignment.
Yeah. Definitely.
Next.
I'll go. Jed now feels that he has faced the most terrifying thing in this area. And as such, everything else is sort of small potatoes. So he's going to will his horse onward in a straight direction, at least, and ride past all these horrifying images. And use animal handling to just keep his horse focused on running. That is a 17.
Along the way, you see a ghostly form of a woman you recognize to be your mother cooing over a bassinet.
I purposely, like, try to avert my eyes and just focus on the spurs.
Temperance.
I try to persuade myself that was all worth it.
Nice.
That's perfect.
I crit.
Wow! You are so self-deluded, it's best, amazing.
Best decision ever.
Woo! Vacation on vacation again.
Gray skies and colors clear.
I sold my soul for a kid.
Everything's coming up roses. Especially Gideon.
Gideon's coming up. Gideon's not pushing up roses.
That's what Paul wrote notes. Why am I here? This is the worst.
I'm honestly beginning to think Gideon wasn't worth it. I mean, Elks is really cool. His dice are, like, on point.
Oh my god.
This is gonna be a goddamn shit show when Doc comes back to the party. He's like,
what did you fuckers do?
You have an undead child and you lost part of your memory.
Gideon was bad.
Oh no!
Alright. I'm kidding. I'm so kidding. I'm so sorry.
Gideon's gonna be there.
He's not really sorry. I mean, he's a monster. Alright. Let's rein it in. As you said before, successfully delude yourself into believing that this bargain you achieved was worth the cost. And when the border of the town of Dog's Bend approaches, you get this warmth in your body you haven't felt in some time. Like you're finally back to a place that is less maddening than the spirit land. However, you're all marked from the occasion. Everyone gains one status of the bizarre miscellaneous thing I haven't named yet, which is, for the three of you, it's disadvantage on your wisdom saving throws.
Which I already had.
We all have that?
Yep.
Okay. So I've just got the first stage, at least.
What was the other thing I forgot what it was?
You only regain half the hit points when you recover hit points.
You only regain half the hit points when you recover hit points. And for you, at stage 2, you must make a wisdom saving throw before every attack roll.
Oh!
Everything has sanctuary.
That's
So half HP from all heals.
Yep.
Including hit dice?
Yep.
Okay. And disadvantage on saving throws? On wisdom saving throws?
Yep.
Wait, I'm confused. So I don't... Gideon didn't have any of this shit.
Gideon doesn't.
Okay, but Elk does now.
Elk does.
Yeah.
Just the he only has one.
The level 1 version of it.
The disadvantage on wisdom saves is level 1. Okay.
Yeah. And half healing.
And what?
Half
heal.
Half healing. Yeah.
You get half the hit points.
Anytime something heals you, you only get half of it. Including your
runes. We need to fix that. Greater restoration would probably do the job.
That's what we get for going to Spooky Town.
Yeah, but it was cool.
Everybody likes Spooky Town. I really liked
it. It was very spooky.
Yeah, I was spooked out.
Levi was prepared to do this whole thing alone.
Should have eaten.
Yeah, well, fuck that. I mean,
you guys just had
to
blow it up.
You should have just cut a bitch.
Well, I needed a +1 gun to do it. Now I can go back and kill her later.
Dude, if she is what I think she is, we wouldn't have even been able to hurt her.
The nightiest of hags.
Maybe.
She was wearing a hag nightie.
I know, and it was really hot. But I was so focused on that.
That's funny.
Hag jerky.
She was hag jerky. All right. So we wordlessly make our way through the spooky lands.
Yep.
Back to where we were. I have a new trophy. It's a nun habit.
It is moth-eaten, 100 years old.
Yep.
It's a double antique.
I'm headed to the let's head to the church and see if a miracle has occurred.
You too?
Yeah, let's go.
What time of the day is it?
It's 1993. We went ahead in time.
I'm going to say
it's a casino.
It's early hours of the morning because you set out right around like late morning.
Yeah.
Rode out, had this interaction, came back.
I mean, but time really doesn't have any meaning there. You could make it any time of day you wanted it.
Maybe it passed strangely for us and we're just coming back the next day. Although maybe it doesn't feel like we've been out for a day.
I'm going to call about 2 a.m.
Wow, very early. The church is probably closed up.
0 hour. I mean, it's a tent, so like...
Oh, right, yeah, yeah.
Flap open,
but... Yeah, my bad. Okay. Yeah. Alright. Open, flap.
Right in. Servo arms engage.
Yep.
Hey, Ripley opens the flap. Yep. Get away from her, you bitch.
What do you... Oh, and before we go in... So what do we owe you?
You owe me nothing.
You are the most decently priced guy we have.
I'm actually like immensely confused that he would ask me.
You would give me a handful of coin. You were willing to sell yourself.
Right.
And you
for the good of that, for the good of them.
Very strange people.
And it's called self-sacrifice. For the good of a tribe.
Okay.
Classic Indian saying.
It's a civilization thing you might not understand.
Look, man, I'm from the...
Your butthole.
He was raised by Confederates. He's
yep, you're a Southern racist.
It's going to come out.
He exists.
All right, but yes, headed to the tent.
Mm-hmm. Gideon is there in a black suit, laying prone.
You want to do the honors, Temperance?
I run up to him and, pat his face, put my hand on his chest, check to see if he's breathing.
You touch the skin, it's cool to touch. There is a moment where you feel that nothing has changed. The skin is gray, ashen. You can see the veins under the skin. It's a bright blue under his skin. And when you think you've been bamboozled, under your hand.
Gideon? Gideon, wake up! Wake up, boy! It's time to get up!
Color starts slowly bleeding back into his face.
I start shaking him. Gideon, get up, boy! It's time to get up now. You open your eyes.
Such characters.
Let me change my hat.
Do I get up?
Take it.
Mom? Blinks. Is Temperance? What are you doing? Huh? What are you doing? What happened?
My boy. And I give him a huge hug. Just sort of tackle him to the floor.
I will give a quick smirk to Jed and to Elk. And just give a little bow and leave. Back to the barber house.
I'm hugging back, but I'm very weird. Like I don't know what's happened. So it's kind of half.
I'm just very... I don't understand. I don't understand what happened. I don't understand.
Oh, you were hurt real bad. We thought you were... we thought you weren't going to make it back with us.
I remember falling. And then I just saw this light. And it seemed to go forever. And I don't know how long. And then I woke up.
Well, you're back, boy. I didn't lose any faith in you. I knew you'd come back.
And then I just start crying. Yeah, he just starts crying.
Oh. You little bastard. That's what you get for falling asleep on watch. You little bastard.
Ben's like, I'm going to create a character. So you like it.
Yeah, then I'm going to kill him.
Mr. Blackburn, you too? You were there? You were there?
I didn't mean to go there.
All right, Dorothy.
I just kind of did.
Aw, oh, Mr. Blackburn, it seems you found the heart you were looking for all along.
Paul.
Yes.
Kurt Gideon's character sheet.
He has
some things to change.
Set it on fire.
Is this the right one?
You know, our 57th level warlock.
No, you're going to write this in.
Oh, sorry.
Let me know when you're ready.
Yeah, I'm going to write on the back so I can clean it up later.
Dark vision 60 feet.
Oh, God.
You have resistance to fire damage.
I'm a drow?
No, that's not a tiefling.
Oh, God.
You gain a hellish rebuke one per day.
Yeah, oh, God.
You gain vulnerability radiant damage.
I guess I really am Damien now.
Yeah.
Dun, 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 dun.
That's it.
You have disadvantage on saving throws.
All of them.
All of them. No, not all of them. From fey creatures and their effects. Outwardly, nothing has changed.
Okay.
And you as a character have no idea anything has changed. But these are now mechanics that are part of your character sheet.
Okay.
Lol.
And Levi's not there when you wake up, of course.
He wanted
you guys to have the glory.
Jet's not useless. I have to make a wisdom saving throw for every attack roll and I have disadvantage on it.
Yep.
That sucks.
And of course, Levi asks nothing in return from any of you.
Before Elku runs, who's now Elku limps, because he probably should have changed his name. No, before he leaves, you're the only one present when he goes to leave.
Walking my way back to the barber's house, I'm not hard to hear.
Some deals. Nobody wins.
Then I suppose I'm the winner in this case. You and I, both.
I have not won anything. And I don't think you have either. I think you misunderstand what has happened. I think you've all misunderstood what has happened. This is both good and bad.
Well, then enlighten me, then.
I doubt you would listen.
I'm listening right now. But if you have nothing worthwhile to say, I'm going to be getting to bed.
You talk more than you listen. I have no more to say. And he just starts walking.
That was completely pointless. I had the opportunity to learn something, and you just walked away. You foolish old man.
I just keep walking.
Get!
You're bucking up for the night? With now a living Gideon?
Yes.
We're not bucking up with
Gideon. Night of the living Gideon.
Is it going to be hand quotes now?
Yes. You're quite living. If he detects undead, you do not flag undead. You don't flag fiendish. You just have the qualities that I have outlined for you.
Okay.
Levi prays and hopes that he is able to shed this desire to have his cake and eat it too. Because that is one of my character flaws, actually.
So
have cake and eat it too.
Yeah.
When Jed goes to bunk down, he lays down and he can hear the faint telltale heartbeat of the revolver. And at first he's, you know, and he's used to sleeping with his guns right on the night table. And he's like, this sound's keeping me awake. I can't listen to it. And he puts it away like in a closet, buried under a blanket and a pillow, and tries to go back to bed. And then he realizes it's even harder to fall asleep.
The telltale revolver. From
it. Yeah. So he gets it out of the closet and he falls asleep with it in his hand.
It's fucking grim.
This turned into quite the gothic horror we got going.
Yeah. Next day, by the way, I can go to question marks.
I believe I can also go to question marks, although I don't have an infinite amount prepared.
I'm kind of starting.
It's one page. We're literally not even halfway through it, are we?
Well, let's go to the next plot point. in the morning, Levi will
I hope I'm ready to play friggin' creepy undead Gideon.
Levi wants to visit Cornelius.
Yeah. He eventually comes to church, like it's his whole job.
I'll probably be there, just waiting and praying.
Yep. He puts a hand on your shoulder when he walks in.
Good morning, Cornelius.
Good morning, Levi.
I have a donation to make to your church, if I may.
You're welcome.
A relic, a holy relic that I discovered in the Lost Lands, the Valley.
Okay.
Pull out the habit. All that remains of her. Saint Agatha herself.
He looks at it sort of skeptically.
Whatever she was, whatever people believe her to have been, I think you should have it. Give this town some semblance of hope, maybe.
I thank you, sir.
You didn't notice anything strange last night, did you?
No, sir. It was a quiet night.
It was indeed.
I slept sound.
Well, Cornelius, thank you for the faith you provide to these people. And I wish you luck in the future. I will be heading off soon. If there's any help I can give you this morning before I go.
Or perhaps a hug, sir.
A hug. Your wish is my command. I give him a hug.
He goes in for a hug. He gives you the back pat. Mm-hmm. I wish you safe travels.
Of course. May God bless you and your people.
And you and yours.
Alright. Then I will pay a visit to Grayson. In the camp.
Yep. He's still turning to his crazy people.
Mm-hmm.
He looks a little better. Like he actually got a little sleep last night.
Good morning, Grayson.
Good morning, sir.
We have completed our ventures into the Valley of Lost Souls. What was it called? You know what I'm talking about.
The Spirit Lands?
That's it.
Yeah.
We have survived, not unscathed, but in a way we found what we were looking for. What was it you were seeking?
Persuasion check, please.
9.
Bam.
What did he say?
A man.
A tall man. And I begin to describe the man,
the mount.
The mount.
No.
All right, then.
Relic. By God.
We encounter, you should probably know as a courtesy, that there is a danger there. Woman, crisp of a thing, tries to make. She will offer deals. If you and your men recover, or if you seek to go in yourself, be wary of her. Choose your words carefully. And, well, if you want to make a deal, be prepared to give up very much.
So I make no deals, sir.
I'm simply warning you. I'm not offering any deals, I am simply telling you what I saw.
I serve the will of the Lord. be she the Lord, I will listen to her ideas.
Well, that fills me with confidence, then. Now, listen, I was wondering, would you tell me what exactly... Well, I need to phrase this very, very carefully.
Very carefully. How many points do you have, out of curiosity?
Hold on. Okay, well, first he'll just say, are any of our men wounded? Or rather, are they sick? Apart from the spiritual disease?
They're all sick, but not of the influenza and cholera sort.
And I'm afraid my services may do no good. But tell me, your people have been of great fascination to me since I passed through up north. What? Now, here's how I'll phrase it. What is your congregation seeking, and how might I and my companions help your cause? Suggestion.
And
feel free to tell me everything you can. Yes.
He has a 16.
That's not enough. So it'll just be a simple persuasion check if you prefer.
Persuasion's perfectly fine.
Yeah. That is a 10. He's probably remains tight-lipped about it.
Yeah, he says, we seek just to enlighten the people, to speak truly of our prophet's interactions with the archangel, and to bring message of heaven to those who would follow God's whims or disregard them.
Fair enough. Well, I wish you luck. You may want to find a way to get your men out of here, so you might regroup and have, well, more healers look at them. Maybe offer them asylum of some sort. In any case, we appreciate your company and all you are doing. And I bid you good day.
I was just going to say, I would have imagined that when Elk runs, before he left, he would have dropped by this place and made a bunch of poultices for them, just to help them.
Maybe I see him working.
No, I probably would have left before morning.
Okay.
You may have seen a pile of them, like, after.
A genuinely good aligned thing.
Some elk leavings.
Nope.
Some elk pellets.
Elk sweepings.
Yeah. Way better than elk egg pellets.
Yeah.
They're Fort Gideon.
Okay. Then Levi will prepare to go and assume that our homeboy is at his location right now.
Homeboy is on site.
Yeah, this is where he sought to go, right?
Yes. Cool. Yeah. He is currently operating his business, trying to make enough money to buy 2 horses.
Cool. Okay. Then I'll simply wait somewhere conspicuous for my companions. If there's something to smoke or to drink, Levi will be doing it.
Both. Easily.
Cool.
Right now, the big thing is peyote is, like, everywhere.
I'm not going to go that far, but I will take some if they give it to me. I will store some for later.
Yeah, it's like the drinking booze during Prohibition. Like, everybody has it, but nobody talks about it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not hard for you with your massive persuasion and gigantic charisma to find it.
Yeah.
Effort whatsoever.
A little bit farewell to the barber couple. Thank them very much. Yeah.
They are genuinely happy to have met you. This town has received you very warmly.
Yeah.
They've been through a lot. They've had some difficult times, but you guys have been very respectful in your time here, and they appear to have genuinely appreciated your presence briefly in the town.
All right. Now just wait for my companions. Whilst bathing in the sun.
Bathing in the sun, you do see that there is a young man who comes out, and he is bringing with him a large water canteen. And another, maybe half a dozen other very young men, 16, 17,
mm-hmm.
are passing the canteen around and having a very good time. And you know enough to know they're drinking booze.
Is it early in the morning?
Oh, yeah.
Damn.
And you come to realize that you haven't seen any brewers or distillers or purveyors of alcoholic beverage in town at all. This seems to be a very dry town, and some teenage kid got his hands on some booze.
All right. Well, if they look in my direction, I'll simply smile and tip of the hat.
They do.
Give him a wink, like, and like that finger point, like oh yeah.
Come on, you. Yeah.
Like, I see you. You get on with your bad self.
They appreciate that and seem to enjoy it even more.
Yeah.
As they get a little drunk and rowdy. Having fun in town.
Is there a person who would sharpen knives in town?
Yes, absolutely.
I'd like to visit that person.
Yeah, they are happy to do so for you. Just sharpening a knife?
Well, I'm going to approach him and pull my Bowie knife out and point to him and say, you know, I long forgot how I did this, but I got this big ugly divot in the blade of my knife. Big old notch here. Can you grind that out for me?
Oh, yeah. He doesn't even charge you. It's a thing he does.
For the life of me, I can't remember why I haven't done this yet. Anyways, thank you.
Okay. Closes it up, hands it back. You get his name. It's Todd Daybach.
Can you spell that for me?
Todd. Daybach is D-E-Y-B-A-C-H. You didn't charge him. He's happy to do it. It takes him a minute, if that. He's not a dick about it.
It's good.
People around here just seem nice. They're a little on edge, you know, with the Native American attacks and rumors thereof. And being their close proximity to these unsettled lands.
Actually, I'm kind of short of money at the moment. Anybody offer pay for gun hand work? Bounty hunter would like?
They only use money here. Is a barter.
Yeah, he says, nobody around here really deals in paper money. I'm out here to avoid the trappings of the East.
I'll take work in barter, if it's available.
Really sharpening knives and, you know, oiling blades and fixing farm equipment. I can give you a fair meal. My wife makes good turnips.
Well, it is an offer that I'm going to regret refusing, but I think the world is calling. Thank you, Mr. Daybach, and for the knife.
Tilts his hat. Come see me again anytime. Information gathering in town. I gave you a couple leads before you set out into the Spirit Lands. We recall there were some things Levi uncovered and shared with the group. With a little more time to pursue it, though each of you are perhaps a little bit less inclined to socialize than you would normally be in the events of the last several days. You get a little information about your friend up in the camp there. He appears to have only come here very recently, maybe in the past 2 weeks or so. Came in.
Grayson.
Mm. Yeah. Grayson brought a large group, 40 or 50 people here, which is like half the population of the town. Was rebuffed. Didn't really have a place to stay. They didn't have structures. There wasn't a lot going on. They built their camp town to the north, and that was that. You hear that a lot of those guys used to come into town a lot, and then they started getting weird, and they stopped coming to town maybe a month ago. You also get a lot of information about this crazy woman who lives out in the Spirit Lands, who makes deals with desperate travelers. A lot of people use her as an allegory for Satan.
Thanks, Satan.
It's pronounced Satine.
You hear some rumors about a place called the Crossroads Gambling House. Crossroads is out near Salt Lake. And stories around here from these God-fearing folk are that it was literally built by Lucifer himself.
Oh, awesome.
The devil himself constructed this casino.
That's metal.
Yeah, I want to go to it now, like, really bad. Not Jed, me.
I heard it's really cold there, though.
By Satan.
You've also heard a few other rumors about a town called St. Jordan.
St. Jordan.
Sorry?
Jordan.
St. Jordan is in Salt Lake County as well. Southern border of the lake, I think. And the reason St. Jordan comes up is because people are talking about this murderer. It's a fantasy tale. People who are left without their blood, sometimes they're beheaded.
Yeah, that sounds like syphilis.
Actually, it was a weather balloon.
That's pump gas.
A vorpal swamp
gas. It was the Aurora Borealis. But yeah, you hear stories about that. In St. Jordan, they got this problem with the serial killer who drains his victims of their blood and occasionally takes their heads. It's a fanciful tale. The kids tell it a lot.
It's an umpire.
That's a different thing. Oh. You also hear tale of somebody by the name of... Let me consult my notes. Abner Wilkes.
Abner Wilkes. Okay.
He's a former soldier for the Confederate Army. And he appears to be very invested in helping the people out here defend themselves from the Injun threat.
Racist.
Huge racist.
He was recruiting recently in town.
We just missed him.
Less than a week ago. He was recruiting able-bodied men and women. And they say he's a patriot who seeks to liberate assets from the federal army because they are unwilling to stand up against the native threat.
Gigantic racist.
Well, that part just sounded like thievery.
Yeah. Yeah, terrorism, actually. Terroristic thievery motivated by racism.
He was going to loot explosives and ammunition.
Yeah, terrorist.
From a federal caravan riding north from Nevada.
So we need to kill a bunch of people and then go gamble at the crossroads.
We've already made a deal with Satan. We just need to murder a bunch more people and then gamble at the crossroads.
I'm surprised Satan didn't offer us, like, comped rooms at the casino.
Right?
You know, as part of the deal that we made. Like,
first spins free.
Yeah. Thanks for coming. You can drink at the blackjack table all night, and here's a room.
You know. Leave your soul when you depart.
Yeah, right?
Don't you have somebody you want to kill, Mr. Blackbird? I thought that's why we were all out here in the middle of this nowhere.
Yep.
When I can reconnect with them, let me know.
Yes, this is prime time for roleplay.
Okay.
It's an all skate.
Good. Good morning, my dear friends. Gideon, did you sleep well?
Yeah.
Good.
He's done enough sleeping for all of us, I guarantee that.
Well, I'm sure he has, Jedediah. Now, shall we get back on that thing of yours?
I don't really know which direction we're going to have the most success in.
Then shall we keep our names for the next town as well?
Wheelbarrow position?
I'm starting to think that Abel is pretty good. Abel Abernathy.
Could be Joshua. That was a good Joshua.
Joshua was a fine name. Handsome name. Heroic name.
Charming.
You know, if I recall, he cut off many foreskins of Israelites in the Bible. Hero. He says that with a chuckle.
Chet unconsciously, like, adjusts his pants.
That, But, of course, a biblical references aside, are we all ready to go? I've finished my business here.
Well, we got a number of leads. Which one do you think is going to pan out the best for us?
I'm focused on finding your man, Jed.
As am I, but...
Sir Joshua, excuse me.
I'm not sure which one of these leads will get us there.
Was your man a gambler?
I fear to say I didn't know the man that intimately.
Fair enough.
But, a gambling house would present us with the opportunity to rub shoulders with the most people.
All the info that you told us, Ben, that's shared information. Well, considering the past that you've told me about, we may want to hook up with this recruiter. You're the man with great ambitions of liberating assets and showing those engines who's boss.
Well, and there's some wisdom in that this man is in Wayne County, and that was our last lead. Everything else takes us to the Salt Lake, which is way up yonder.
I think we should follow the trail of this recruiter.
Abner Wilkes, then.
Abner Wilkes, yes. And I'm quite interested to talk to him.
Well, unless we have any dissent?
No, none at all.
I think we've done enough gambling for the time being.
Levi looks at you guys
with a smile, like... like, not quite a smile, more of like a, yeah, done enough gambling.
You done cocked up, fuckheads.
Yeah.
Gideon, do you have any input on which way you think we should go?
I just don't want to stay here. We need to move.
Of course.
Need to move on.
Well, you heard the boy. Saddle up.
Cousin, you mind if I hold on to this name a little longer?
Of course. Use it well.
I do hope so.
May it treat you better than it's treated me.